In the previous video, I showed you how to model areas inundated by sea level rise at various heights. In this video, I will show you how to create a raster dataset based on land use categories. On the Humboldt State Geospatial Online website, I am currently on step 15. However, just for future reference, these numbers sometimes change. Before you start, take a moment to clean up the table of contents. Remove all of the layers except for the inundation rasters. Add the land use layer to the table of contents. In the table of contents, right-click the land use layer and open the attribute table. If this is the first time opening an attribute table, it might appear floating above the map. It is helpful to dock the attribute table to the bottom. Take a moment to look at the attribute data. Under the field EXLU4, you will see a number of land use categories. Because the land use categories are stored as text, we won't be able to use this type of data in the raster calculator. In the next few steps, you're going to create a field that will store the land use categories as numbers that can be used in the raster calculator. You will also group some of the land use categories together as well. This means that some land use categories will be assigned the same number. To make the attribute data easier to work with, I'm going to create a summary table. Right-click on the heading EXLU4 and select Summarize. You can leave all the settings as default. Click the yellow file folder icon and browse to the working folder. I'll call the file UseCode Table. Change the file type to DBase Table. When you are ready, click Save, then OK. Go ahead and add the table to the map. When you add a table to the table of contents, it automatically switches view from List by Drawing Order to List by Source. It is important to remember that while you are in List by Source view, you won't be able to rearrange the layer order. In the List by Source view, you can see the file paths of each layer. Raster data is grouped separately. Here you can see that all of my data is in the working folder. If you accidentally saved any of your layers to the default geo database, you will see that here as well. Hopefully you didn't do that. Right-click on the UseCode table and select Open. As you can see, the summary table is an abridged version of the original attribute field. It is made up of only the unique values for the EXLU4 field. Next to the land use categories, this table also provides the total number of parcels that fall into each class. In this step, I'm going to assign a number to specific categories. On the UseCode table, I'll add a new field. I'll name the field UseCode. Since the field will only hold small numbers with no decimal places, I will make it a short integer. On the Humboldt State Geospatial Online website, I have a list of numbers that I will assign to each land use category. First, I'll use Select by Attributes to select the land use category. The first one is City. Then I'll use the field calculator to change the use code to 1. I'll repeat these steps for each group. The next one is Agriculture, including timber production, which will get a value of 2. The next group is all categories of residential or places where people live, which will get a use code of 3, and so on. Now the summary table is ready to join back to the original land use shapefile. To avoid mistakes, I recommend that you switch back to List by Drawing Order in the table of contents. Right-click on the land use layer in the table of contents, select Joins and Relates, then Join. On the Join Data window, use a drop-down menu to select the use codes table under number 2. It might appear automatically. Under number 1, use the drop-down menu to select the EXLU4 field. The same field will automatically appear next to number 3. When you are ready, click OK. The use codes table is now joined to the land use shapefile. You can view this by opening the land use layer attribute table. You will see the use code table appended on the right. A table join is only temporary. To make this change permanent, export the shapefile. Save the file to your working folder. I'll call this one Land Use with Codes. Add the new shapefile to the map and remove the original land use layer. In the ARC toolbox, open the Conversion Tools, then To Raster. Double-click the Polygon to Raster tool. For the input, use the Land Use with Codes layer. For the value field, select the use codes field. Click the yellow file folder icon and save the file to the working folder. I'll call this one Land Use. We want the cell size of this raster to match up exactly with the digital elevation model. Under Cell Size, use the yellow file folder icon and browse to the original folder. Choose the digital elevation model. Leave all the other settings as default and click OK. After the tool finishes, remove the Land Use with Code shapefile from the table of contents. You won't be needing it anymore. What you have left is a raster layer representing the land use categories. Each pixel will be assigned a number ranging from 1 through 9. In the next video, I will show you how to use the raster calculator to determine the impact of sea level rise on the different land use categories.